As parents, we are given a wonderful privilege and responsibility of raising our children who belongs to God, not to us, to know and love Him. Our responsibility as Christians is to care for our children's souls as much as we care for their physical needs. Why should we pray for our children? In the book of Matthew chapter 7 verse 14 tells us, "But the gateway to life is very narrow, and the road is difficult, and only a few ever find it." So it is our job as believers in Jesus Christ to pray for our children in order for them to find the narrow gate that leads to life. Raising children into this world is very challenging. There are many temptations to entice them. This is why we need to depend on God. As parents, we can dictate the choices our children will make and the spiritual door they will walk through, either the narrow gate or the wide gate. This is why it is so important for us to lay hands on our children with prayers as often as we can. Luke 18 verse 1 through 8 encourages us as Christians to persevere in our faith against all odds. As parents, we should pray regularly, bring every concern, every dream, and desire about our children to God in fervent and persistent prayers. We should pray for our children when they're on their way to school and at bedtime, regardless of their age. The sooner you start doing this with them, the better. Pray for their future mate, relationships, activities, challenges, temptation, and a heart for God. Pray for your child to have a strong Christian friends. Ask God to protect your child daily from others who will be an evil influence. Also consider asking God to help you spot your child's doing things right, so that we can encourage them in making the right choices. Pray for God to remove any questionable character from our child's life. Our children are under constant attack from the world and the flesh and the devil. We should not relent, but consistently commit our children to the hands of their Maker for them to survive in this crazy world. Each day, our children are subjected to literally thousands of offensive images on the internet and televisions. Diligent prayer helps us focus on what is truly important in the lives of our children. As we focus on the Lord, our goals for our children are more in line with God's goal for our children. Remember, they belong to God. With that in mind, it becomes clear that we should seek His will through prayer on all matters pertaining to our children's lives. As parents, we should be asking ourselves, is prayer for our children the normal part of our daily lives, or it is something we do only when we feel helpless? The truth is, we can never pray enough. We need power from God to do all He calls us to do, and so do our children. In addition, we are raising our children in a world with values contrary to our own, a world that seeks to attack and destroy our children. We cannot defend them against all these attacks, but we can always pray. Prayer is powerful, and His words are true. I am aware more than ever of just how much our kids need our prayers. It is one of the most important gifts we could ever give to them in this life. God knows our hearts. He sees, He hears, and is always at work, even when we cannot fully see Him. Praying biblical blessings over our children is an effective way to bring God's blessing into our children's lives and see His power work in our children's hearts. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we praise You for Your love and faithfulness. We thank You for Your protection and care over our families. Thank You that You give us the power to love well, the wisdom to lead and teach our children. We know You are for us, that You fight for our families today. You are our Redeemer, our Restorer and Friend. We believe You have good in store for us. We confess some days parenting is tough. Many days we can feel anxious or overwhelmed. We ask that You make us more like You, more aware of Your constant presence in our lives. Help us to release our children to You, so that You are free to fully accomplish all that You desire in them, through them. Fill our families with Your truth and cover us with Your favor, Lord. We pray for these blessings over our children today and every day. Father, I pray for Your belief over my children. Your word says in Acts 16 verse 31, "If we believe in the Lord Jesus, and we will be saved with our household." Father, I pray for Your blessings over my children. Your word says in Numbers 6 verse 24 to 26, "The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn His face toward you and give you peace." Lord, I pray for Your courage over my children. Your word says in Joshua 1 verse 9, "Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go." Father, I pray for contentment over my children. Your word says in Hebrews 13 verse 5, Keep your life free from love of money, and be content with what you have, for he has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. Father, I pray for encouragement over my children. Your word says in Ephesians 4 verse 29, do not let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouths, but only what is helpful for building others up according to their needs, that it may benefit those who listen. Father, I pray for endurance over my children. Your word says in Hebrews 12 verse 22, therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and sin which clings so closely, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, fixing our eyes on Jesus. Father, I pray for faithfulness over my children. Your word says in 1 Samuel 12 verse 24, only fear the Lord and serve him faithfully with all your heart, for consider what great things he has done for you. Father, I pray for favor over my children. Your word says in Psalm 5 verse 12, for you bless the righteous, O Lord. You cover him with favor as with a shield. Father, I pray for forgiveness over my children. Your word says in 1 John 1 verse 9, if we confess our sin, he is faithful and just and will forgive us our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness. Father, I pray for fruitfulness over my children. Your word says in Galatians 5 verse 22 to 23, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Father, I pray for generosity over my children. Your word says in 1 Timothy 6 verse 18 to 19, they are to do good, to be rich in good works, to be generous and ready to share, thus storing up treasure for themselves as a good foundation for the future, so that they may take hold of that which is truly life. Father, I pray for godly relationships over my children. Your word says in Proverbs 13 verse 20, whoever walks with the wise become wise, but the companions of fools will suffer harm. Father, I pray for grace over my children. Your word says in 2 Corinthians 13 verse 14, may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Father, I pray for health for my children. Your word says in 3 John 1 verse 2, beloved, I pray that all may go well with you and that you may be in good health as it goes well with your soul. Father, I pray for honesty over my children. Your word says in John 8 verse 32, and you will know the truth and the truth will set you free. Father, I pray for hope over my children. Your word says in Isaiah 40 verse 31, but those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. Father, I pray for humility over my children. Your word says in Philippians 2 verse 3 to 4, do nothing from rivalry or conceit, but in humility count others more significant than yourself. Let each of you look not only to his own interests, but also to the interests of others. Father, I pray for integrity over my children. Your word says in Proverbs 10 verse 9, whoever walks in integrity walks securely, but he who makes his way crooked will be found out. Father, I pray for joy over my children. Your word says in Nehemiah 8 verse 10, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. Father, I pray for kindness over my children. Your word says in Ephesians 4 verse 32, be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, as God in Christ forgave you. Father, I pray for love over my children. Your word says in 1 John 3 verse 1, how great is the love of the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called children of God. Father, I pray for obedience over my children. Your word says in Ephesians 6 verse 1, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Father, I pray for patience over my children. Your word says in James 1 verse 19, know this, my beloved brothers, let every person be quick to hear, slow to speak, and slow to anger. Father, I pray for peace over my children. Your word says in Isaiah 26 verse 3, you keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on you, because he trusts in you. Father, I pray for protection over my children. Your word says in Psalm 91 verse 1, 2, and 4 to 11, he who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. He will cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. He will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. Father, I pray for your provision over my children. Your word says in Philippians 4 verse 19, "And my God will supply every need of yours according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus." Father, I pray for purity over my children. Your word says in Psalm 119 verse 9, "How can a young man keep his way pure? By guarding it according to your word." Father, I pray for your purpose over my children. Your word says in Jeremiah 29 verse 11, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for welfare and not for evil, to give you hope and a future." Father, I pray for respect over my children. Your word says in 1 Peter 2 verse 17, "Show proper respect to everyone, love the brotherhood of believers, fear God, honor the King." Father, I pray for safety over my children. Your word says in Psalm 121 verse 8, "The Lord will watch over your coming and going both now and forevermore." Father, I pray for your salvation over my children. Your word says in John 3 verse 16, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life." Father, I pray for self-control over my children. Your word says in 2 Timothy 1 verse 7, "For God gave us a spirit not of fear, but of power and love and self-control." Father, I pray for a servant heart over my children. Your word says in Galatians 5 verse 13, "For you were called to freedom, brothers. Only do not use your freedom as an opportunity for the flesh, but through love serve one another." Father, I pray for submission over my children. Your word says in James 4 verse 7, "Submit yourself therefore to God, resist the devil, and he will flee from you." Father, I pray for thankfulness over my children. Your word says in Colossians 3 verse 17, "And whatever you do in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him." Father, I pray for trust over my children. Your word says in Proverbs 3 verse 5 to 6, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, submit to him and he will make your path straight." Father, I pray for your value over my children. For your word says in Ephesians 2 verse 9, "For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk with them." Father, I pray for wisdom over my children. Your word says in Proverbs 9 verse 10, "The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom." Father, I pray for wise instruction over my children. Your word says in Isaiah 54 verse 13, "Your sons will be taught by the Lord, and great will be your children's peace." Heavenly Father, please let your blessing and your word shine on my children and my family today as we seek to honor you. In Jesus' name, amen.